Hello everyone, welcome back to the tutorials again. So in previous session we have seen the introduction to pre-stressed concrete, that is module number 3 in your syllabus. So we have just started with the module number 3 in previous session. So you can see over here, today we are going to briefly discuss about the introduction to pre-stressed concrete and materials used for pre-stressed concrete. So you can see what is pre-stress. Pre-stress is defined as method of applying pre-compression to control the stresses resulting due to external loads below the neutral axis of the beam, tension developed due to external load which is more than permissible limit of plain concrete. So what exactly this pre-stress means? Pre-stress means application of compression in priorier or in beginning itself before inducing any stresses. So those stresses are resulting from external loads. So whatever the stresses which are resulting from the external loads are counteracted by the pre-induced compression. So which is below the neutral axis, and those stresses are developed mainly due to external loads. Next, the pre-compression applied may be axial or eccentric, will induce the compressive stress below the neutral axis or whole beam cross section, resulting either no tension or no compression. Means whatever the compression which we induce initially will counteract the stresses which are going to get induced, and both are going to get neutralized either, or else we are going to experience the compression below the neutral axis. So this is the basic concept which we are going to use. Next is, what is pre-stress concept? We are going to see. Pre-stressed concrete is basically a concrete in which internal stresses of suitable magnitude and distribution are introduced so that stresses resulting from external loads are counteracted to desired degree. So what is pre-stressed concrete? Pre-stressed concrete basically is a concrete in which internal stresses of suitable magnitude and distribution are induced in advance. Remember this. Pre-stressed concrete is basically a concrete in which internal stresses of suitable magnitude and distribution are introduced in advance so that stresses resulting from external loads are countered to the desired degree. Next, you can see terminologies which we are going to use. So what are the different terminologies which we are going to use? Let us consider first one, that is tendons. A stretched element used in a concrete member of structure to impart the stresses to the concrete. So generally you can compare these tendons to the steel rods which we induce. Okay, but tendons might be used in bundle. Okay, these are the tendons. Tendons are generally elements which are used in concrete member of structure to impart the stresses. Whatever the stresses which we are going to impart in the beginning, to impart those stresses in the beginning, these tendons are used. So image is shown over here. Next, you can see anchorage, a device generally used to enable the tendons to impart and maintain pre-stress in concrete. So you can see these are the tendons. So these are the wires, we can call, or tendons we can call. So these are the tendons. Whatever the tendons are there, those tendons will be kept in position, and this device helps those tendons to impart and maintain the pre-stress in the concrete. So this is called as anchorage. So it will keep it in position as well as it will helpful in imparting the pre-stress in the concrete. Next, these two are the terminologies which are very useful. that is tendon and anchorage. Next, pre-tensioning and post-tensioning. These are the two methods. We are going to study these methods in detail further. But just as an introduction, a method of pre-stressing concrete in which the tendons are tensioned before. So this is one of the method of pre-stressing the concrete. So in this method, the tendons are tensioned before the concrete is placed. This point is very important. So before concrete is placed, these tendons are stretched, or stresses are induced in the tendons before placing the concrete. In this method, concrete is introduced by bond between steel and concrete. Okay, next, post tensioning, a method of pre-stressing concrete. So this is also a method of pre-stressing concrete by tensioning the tendons against the hardened concrete. Means whatever the tension which we are going to induce through the tendons, that is induced after placing the concrete and after concrete attaining the suitable strength. So after that we are going to induce the stresses in the tendons. So that is called as post tensioning. So in this method, pre-stress is imparted to concrete by bearing. So this is very important. So in pre-tensioning, the concrete is introduced by bond between steel and concrete. So it should be stresses is introduced by bond between steel and concrete. But here stresses are pre-stress is imparted or induced to concrete by bearing. So this is very important. Here it is by bond between steel and concrete. Here it is by bearing. Next, to do all this pre-stressing thing, we need a very different kind of material which are very much different as compared to the materials which we use regularly for the normal RCC. So what are the different characteristics of the material which are required for the pre-stressing concrete member is given below. So you can see, first one is cement. So the cement should be any of the following: ordinary Portland cement conforming to IS 269, Portland slag cement conforming to IS 455, but slag content should not be more than 50%. This is a very important point. Slag content should not be more than 50%. Rapid hardening Portland cement conforming to IS 8041. So these all the things are permitted, or else high strength ordinary Portland cement conforming to IS 8112 is also okay for the pre-stressing concrete, pre-stressing cement. Okay, next, concrete pre-stressing concrete. Pre-stress concrete requires a concrete which has high compressive strength reasonably early, at early age. Means the concrete which we are going to use for pre-stressed concrete is it should be having high compressive strength reasonably at early ages. Means it should have initial high compressive strength with comparatively high tensile strength than ordinary concrete. The concrete for the member shall be air entrained concrete composed of Portland cement, fine and coarse aggregates, admixtures and water. It is a regular. Air entrainment feature may be obtained by use of either air entraining Portland cement or approved air entraining admixture. The entrained air content shall not less than 4% or more than 6%. So air entrained concrete is good for pre-stressed concrete. So for air entraining, we can either use air entraining Portland cement or else approved air entraining admixture. But this air entraining should not be less than 4% and should not be more than 6%. This point is very important. You can mark down this point. Next, minimum cement content of 300 to 360 kg per meter cube is prescribed for durability requirement. So this is the minimum cement content which we have to use. The water content shall be as low as possible. So water content we have to keep as low as possible. Minimum cement content we have to use as 300 to 360 kg per meter cube. Air entrained air content shall be less than 4% and should not be more than 6%. Next, steel. High tensile steel tendons, strands or cables are used. The steel used in pre-stress shall be any one of the following. So plain hard drawn steel wire conforming to IS 1785, cold drawn indented wire conforming to IS 6003, high tensile steel wire bar conforming to IS 2090, uncoated stress relieved strand conforming to IS 6006. Okay, so these are the types of steel which can be used in pre-stressed concrete. So one thing I have forgot to mention, the entrained air content shall not less than 4% or more than 6%. So this is a very important point. Many of the competitive exams, they have asked this question. So you can note this particular point. Next, high strength steel should contain. So what this high strength steel should contain? High strength steel should contain 0.7 to 0.8% of carbon, 0.6% of manganese and 0.1% of silica. Apart from this, whatever the quantities which are mentioned, if the content is more than this, it cannot be used as a pre-stressed steel material. For pre-stressing steel material, it can be used. Durability, fire resistance and cover requirement for PSC members. So according to IS 1343-1918, 20 mm cover for pre-tensioned member is required. So for pre-tensioning, 20 mm cover is required. 30 mm or size of cable, whichever is bigger, for post-tensioned member is required. So remember, for pre-tensioned member, cover is 20 mm. For post-tensioned member, cover is either 30 mm, minimum is 30 mm, or the size of cable, whichever is bigger, that much amount of cover we have to use. If the pre-stress members are exposed to an aggressive environment, these covers are increased by another 10 mm. So what they say is, if the pre-stressed member which we are using are exposed to aggressive environment such as freezing and thawing, excessive heat and all those things, these covers should be, in both the cases, these covers are increased by 10 mm. These covers are increased by minimum 10 mm. So next, necessity of high grade concrete and steel. So what is the necessary of using this high grade concrete and steel is very important. So first one is, higher the grade of concrete, higher the bond strength, which is vital in pre-tensioned concrete. So we need higher bond strength. So by using this bond between steel and concrete, we are going to transfer the stresses to the concrete. So for that purpose, we need higher bond strength. So higher bond strength can be achieved by higher grade of concrete. Also higher bearing strength. So in case of pre-tensioned concrete, we need higher bond strength. But in case of post-tensioned concrete, we need higher bearing strength, so that we can transfer. In case of post-tensioned concrete, the bearing is used to transfer the stresses, and in case of pre-tensioned concrete, the bond is used to transfer the concrete. Okay, further, creep and shrinkage losses are minimum in case of high grade concrete. That is why we need to use the high grade concrete. So this is the necessity of high grade concrete. Next, generally minimum M30 grade of concrete is used for post-tensioned and minimum M40 grade of concrete is used for pre-tensioned member. Remember this is very important. Minimum M30 grade of concrete is used for post-tensioned member and minimum M40 grade of concrete is used for pre-tensioned member. The losses in pre-stress member due to various reasons are generally in the range of 250 Newton per mm square to 400 Newton per mm square. So there are various losses in while transferring the stresses. So these losses might be due to various reasons. We are going to study it in module number 5, which is going to tell us about the losses in pre-stressed concrete. So these losses are due to various reasons. We are going to study that. But if we combine all those losses, the losses in between 250 Newton per mm square to 400 Newton per mm square. If mild steel or deformed steel is used, the residual stress after losses is either zero or negligible. Hence, high tensile stress wires are used, whose strength varies from 1600 to 200 Newton per mm square. So if we use general mild steel or normal deformed bars, so you can see if general mild steel is having characteristic strength of 250 Newton per mm square, Fy is equal to 250 Newton per mm square, or else deformed bars are cold formed bars are having the strength of 415 either 500. So if we consider the losses, it is in between 250 to 400. Then if we use the mild steel or deformed steels, this particular mild steel and deformed steels are going to lose all their strengths in losses itself. So there is no stress which is remaining to transfer. That is why we use high steel wires. So that this is the necessity of using high grade of steel, so which is having the strength of 1600 to 2000 Newton per mm square. So what is the history and development of pre-stressed concrete? So the pre-stressed concrete structure is different from conventional reinforced structure due to application of an initial load on structure prior to its use. So we are going to apply initial load before its use. The initial load or pre-stress is applied to enable the structure to counteract the stresses arising during the service period. So before only we are going to apply the pre-stresses, which is going to helpful in counteracting the stresses which are going to arrive in service period. So this is the major difference between regular concrete and pre-stressed concrete. Next, pre-stressing of structure is not the only instance of pre-stressing. The concept of pre-stressing exists before the application to the concrete. So the concept of pre-stressing was initially discovered long back, but it was not applied to the concrete. So as I have seen, as shown you in the previous session, so these wooden planks are tied by the metal bands. So these metal bands are applied the stresses initially, so that whenever we fill the material inside, that is going to apply the opposite kind of stresses, and that were counteracted by these metal bands. So you can read this explanation. The metal bands induce a stage of initial hoop compression or hoop stress, so to counteract the hoop tension caused by filling liquid in the barrels. So whenever we fill liquid in these barrels, those liquids are going to induce the stresses in outer direction. So these metal straps are going to induce the stresses in inner direction. Both are going to get counteracted. So this was the earlier discovery of pre-stressed concrete. Similarly, bicycle spokes were another example for this. So we can read it. Next, in next session, what we are going to study is what are the forms of pre-stressing steel. So pre-stressing steel might be used in wires, which might be used in strands, or in many ways we are going to use the pre-stressing steel. Means whatever the pre-stressing steel is there, which we are going to use regularly, those pre-stressing steels are in various forms. So what are those forms of pre-stressing and all those things we are going to study in next session. So nature of concrete steel interaction, how the concrete and steel is going to interact in case of pre-stressed concrete, we are going to study. Next, stages of loading, we are going to study in next session. Advantages of pre-stressed concrete, we are going to study in detail, we are going to study in fact. And limitations of pre-stressed concrete, we are going to study in detail. So these are all the things which we are going to study in next session. So I hope you have understood the things which we have discussed today. So just go through it, and if you have any doubts, you can just raise your queries. Thank you.